Very good afternoon. My name is Captain G.S. Rathi. I am the Chief Executive Officer for the upcoming International Aviation Conclave, which is going to be taking place from 9th to 11th of October at India Trade Promotion Organization ITPO, Pragati Maidan, New Delhi. And it is all supported by the Ministry of Civil Aviation, Government of India, the Director General of Civil Aviation, Government of India, the US India Importer Council, then is the ADS UK, and various other national and international bodies. The theme for the inaugural year, which we are taking into accordance, is empowering aviation, encouraging stability towards sustainability. The prime focus of this event, which we are taking into accordance, is the promotion of aviation domain, taking into account the foreign direct investment, global cooperation, liberalized policies by the Government of India, and to showcase growth potential in the Indian economy. The industry leaders will exhibit their products and services before the global aviation arena. And apart from this, the promotion of latest aircrafts with an intention to enhance the regional connectivity, strong focus on general aviation and allied activities. Apart from this, we are focusing on the domestic manufacturing of aircrafts and parts with international corporations and the collaborations. Maintenance, repair, overhauls, aviation safety and security is going to play a vital role. Apart from this, the various allied activities like the ground handling operations, airport infrastructure and development, medical and general tourism, aerospace and aviation medicine, and research and surveillance, along with new trends in information technology, will be the key attractions at this International Aviation Conclave 2014. I personally feel that this event will prove to be a key catalyst for economic growth and socio-political development, which is going to provide excellent platform for business associations and an unrivaled access to the untapped yet highly resourceful Indian aviation market. This first edition of this conclave will prove to be a milestone in achieving stability and sustainability for the global aviation industry, thus empowering aviation worldwide. Apart from this, we are covering conference, we are covering the exhibition part, and we are covering the award night. Under the conference, we have some set of global luminary speakers where we are taking them into accordance just to streamline the policies and the administrative reforms pertaining to the civil aviation domain of India. Some global luminary speakers to be present at the conference in October 2014 are Dr. Naseem Zaidi, who is the present election commissioner of India and former secretary civil aviation, and he had been he had played a vital role, and it's very, very crucial role in building the civil aviation domain. Apart from him, Mr. Jalal Haider is the Director General, World Aviation Forum, and former Vice President, International Civil Aviation Organization. Then we have Mr. Mark Schwab. Mark Schwab, he is a very prominent person and had been into news as he is the Chief Executive Officer for Star Alliance. And recently with Air India, with the inception as a member with the Star Alliance team, is going to play a very vital role. Then apart from that, we have Mr. David Soucy, who is a safety and accident analyst and a senior aviation expert. Then Mr. Greg Principato, Mr. Siddharth Kapoor, President and CFO GMR Airports, Mr. Vijay Poonuswamy, Vice President, International Public Affairs, Etihad Airways. Then we have Mr. Manish Jayakrishnan, Vice President, Sita Group. Then Dr. Kalpana Gopalan, she is an IAS officer from Karnataka Cadre, and she is the Chairman of Karnataka Appellate Tribunal, and she is an expert from the urban development aspect. Mr. Ashok Saxena is a Director, UK Advanced Engineering Representative Office, and former Managing Director, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. Then we have key people like Dr. Professor Yugnin Ziegler, Dr. Yogendra Saxena, Dr. Indu Grewal, and a lot of other eminent personalities. Then we are coming to our exhibition part, and in our exhibition part we are taking up very important key issues where we have some key participants as Sukhoi Civil Aircraft Company, United Aircraft Corporation, Technam, ADS, Club One Air, Ligier Voyages, Hawkeye, Shorey Aeronautics, Global Investments, USIEC, Sparrow Aviation, Pinnacle Air, Citrus Air, Wings Aviation, Sky Cabs, Florida Light Sport Aviation, Rajiv Gandhi Aviation Academy, Shadow Air, Yeti Air Services, and a lot of other organizations. Thereafter, in order to give due appreciation and encouragement to the industry players, we have given outstanding, who has given outstanding services in their respective areas, the International Aviation Awards will take place on the concluding day of the event, where organizations and individuals from more than 25 categories under aviation and allied domains will be awarded. Further on, our main aspect is going ahead towards the development aspect of the untapped yet very resourceful market of India, because if we see the figures, the study suggests that by the year 2020, India is likely to become the third largest aviation market, which is going to handle 336 million domestic and 85 million international passengers, with projected investment to tune of US$120 billion, which is a very, very stupendous figure. And Indian aviation industry has been instrumental in the overall economic development of the country. According to Oxford Economics report commissioned by IATA, indicates that aviation accounts for 1.5% of India's GDP and supports 1.7 million jobs, with a further 7.5 million employed in other sectors, including tourism, through the catalytic effect of aviation. Further, apart from the various aspects of civil aviation domain, we are focusing on a lot of other issues which are pertaining to the aviation safety and security, and we are planning to set up a human capital bank, which is going to take care of the manpower requirements, the skilled manpower requirements of the Indian aviation domain, and we are planning to streamline the policies in this conclave. As very visionary and luminary people who are the policy maker around the globe, they will be present over here in India. Further on, we are planning to give a single window system to the foreign direct investors who are planning to come to India and invest, because time is a critical factor over here. And we should welcome the foreign direct investment and the public-private partnerships. As it is always said by our Honorable Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi ji, and his main focus on foreign direct investment and the public-private partnerships. So I personally feel that this International Aviation Conclave 2014 is going to play a very, very key and very vital role towards the economic development of India. And not only India, I feel that it is going to give a new shape towards our relation to the SAARC countries, because approximately 40% of the economic development lies with the SAARC countries, and aviation is playing a vital role, because it's the key economic mobilizer, because maximum of the transportation takes place via air route or via maritime. So we are putting a best of the focus on the aviation domain, and I feel that this event will give qualitative and quantitative business to India, as well as will provide India a benchmark and will set standards towards the global aviation industry. And we are looking forward for the collaborative effort from all the stakeholders of aviation. It is requested for everyone to come up and to be a part of this visionary event, to participate, to showcase their presence, and to be a part of this visionary move and help in making economically and a safety oriented aviation atmosphere. Thanks.